first going to do is draw out the still life first. I'm going to do one line for the table. So this is the table and this will be the wall. I'm going to also draw the window. And just a big shape for the trees in the background. It's not super detailed, but you know it's trees. And then it lines for the window. Now we can get to the things that are on the table, which is gonna be a pitcher, a bowl, and either lime or lemon. So two limes, two lemons, or lime or lemon. But we're gonna do that first. And I'm going to draw the pitcher first, and it's going to go over the window. It's kind of going to overlap the window, but we're going to erase the lines that are in between there afterwards. But just going around and up to the handle, and then create a little opening and erase part of that. Make it a little wider. There's the handle. Before I erase my lines that are in between, I'm going to finish drawing all of the shapes first. Then we're going to do the bowl. Lemon or lime, just a big kind of oval, and then half moon shape, and then our second, lime or lemon, and another half a moon shape. Now we're going to erase these lines that are in between. Since cubism is sort of separating the objects into shapes, we're going to separate each of these pieces and add lines so that it looks like it's a lot of shapes. You're kind of separating it into different shapes of each object, just like a bunch of shapes put together that make the picture. So first we're going to do the table. I'm going to do up to 5 lines for this. Keep it a little simple. All of our lines do not have to be the same, but I want you to do at least 3, and the most you can do is 5. And for the pitcher, we're gonna go with the curve of the pitcher. Another little line that serves as the back. For the inside, I'm just going to do 2 lines. And the bowl, I'm also going to go kind of with the curvy lines. And for the inside, I'm just going to do 1 line. I think the last shape we're going to separate is the trees and the window, and then the background. Now for the trees, I've done about maybe 3 lines. Keep it a little simple. Wherever you want to put them, you don't have to put them in the same place that I do, but just have up to about 3 to 4 maybe. And for the wall, I'm going to keep it very simple and just do 1 big line so we have two different shapes. I'm just going to do diagonal, going that way. Now we're going to go over it with our black crayon. So we have really thick lines that the watercolor will not bleed into the other shapes. It'll stay in the shapes. Once you've done that, if there are any pencil marks that you want to erase, you can. I'm going to just erase a few that I see that I don't want to show in my paint. But once you've done that, then you can go in with the color, either with watercolors, crayons, or markers.